Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Welcome to my YouTube channel Calculus and Mathematics Learning. In the previous video, we learned our question number 3 related with exercise number 2.5 relevant with chapter number 2 differentiation second year mathematics. In today's video, I am going to solve question number 4, 5 and 6, the last 3 questions of exercise number 2.5. So let's move toward question number 4. It tells that let a minus b u cube minus time of a plus b v square is equal to c, where a, b, c are constant. Find du by dv and dv by du. Du by dv means that derivative of u with respect to v, and dv by du means the derivative of v with respect to u. So let's take the given equation, which is a minus b u cube minus time of a plus b v square is equal to c. This is given. That is that a, b and c, these are the constant. And taking now, we are going to find the derivative of u with respect to v. So with respect to v means that we will derive it first of both sides of the equation with respect to v. So taking the derivative with respect to t, so d by dv of a minus b u cube minus d by dv of a plus b v square is equal to d by dv of a constant c. Now a minus b is a constant, so take it outside, so it becomes a minus b. Derivative of u cube is a 3u square, but here u is the inner function because du by dv. So we will write du by dv minus time of a plus b is a constant, and the derivative of v square is a 2v. Now after this is equal to derivative of a constant is a 0. So it becomes a 3u square multiply a minus b du by dv will be equal to a minus b and 2v. Shift this to the right hand side, it becomes plus a plus b multiply to v. Now divide both sides with 3u square a minus b. 3u square a minus b. 3u square a minus b. So 3u square a minus b is cancelled on this side. So we are left with du by dv is equal to a plus b into 2v, or 2v into a plus b divided by 3u square into a minus b. This is the required result for du by dv. Now we are going to find dv by du. So we will derive it both sides with respect to u. So taking the derivative with respect to u, so a minus b is a constant, bring it outside. And derivative of u cube will be 3u square minus time of a plus b. Derivative of v square is 2v. But here the inner function is v, so we will write dv by du. Dv by du is equal to derivative of a constant c is 0. Now after this, shift a minus b 3u square to the right hand side, it becomes minus time of a minus b into 3u square. And by shifting it to the right hand side, it becomes minus time of minus a minus b 3u square. And we are left with minus time of a plus b dv by du. Now after this, minus cancel out with minus and divide both sides with a plus b into 2v. A plus b into 2v. So on this side, a plus b and 2v are cancelled with each other. We are left with 3u square multiply a minus b divided by 2v multiply a plus b. This is the required result for dv by du. So this is the answer for question number 4. Now move to the next question. Question number 5. It tells that determine slope of tangent line to the curve 3x square minus 7y square plus 14y is equal to 27 at the point minus 30. Now taking the given curve, which is 3x square minus 7y square plus 14y is equal to 27. Now we are going to find the slope. You know that slope is actually equal to the derivative of dy by dx. So it means that we are going to find dy by dx. Here the in denominator we have x. So it means that we will differentiate both sides with respect to x. So taking the derivative with dy dx of each variable alone. So minus d by dx of 7y square d by dx of 14y is equal to d by dx on the right hand side, which is 27. Now you know that derivative of 3x square is 6x, and the derivative of 7y square will be 14y, and you know that y is an inner function, so it becomes dy by dx plus 14 time of derivative of y will be dy by dx because this is the inner function, will be equal to the derivative of a constant is 0. Now on this side, take out dy by dx common, we are left with 14 and minus 14 y. dy by dx common we are left with 14 and minus 14y, and shift 6x to right hand side, it becomes negative 6x. Now we are going to find the derivative at the value minus 3 and 0. This is x and this is y. So now putting the values, it becomes dy by dx will be equal to the minus 6x divided by 14 minus 14y. So our required result will be dy by dx will be equal to minus 6 times of x. X is minus 3. Divided by 14 times of 14 minus 4y. So y is 0. So y multiply 4 gives us 0. So we are left with minus 6 minus 3 gives us 18 divided by 14. Now divide numerator and denominator with 2. We are left with dy by dx will be equal to the 9 divided by 7. So this is the required derivative and this is the required slope to the given curve at a point minus 3, 0. Now move to question number 6, the last question of today's lecture and the last question of exercise number 2.5. It tells that the graph of x cube y cube plus 4y is equal to 3x square. It is a curve that passes through the point 2, 1. What will be the slope of this curve at that point, which is 2, 1? Let's suppose this is our x value and this is y value. Now we are going to take the given curve, which is x cube y cube plus 4y is equal to 3x square. This is the given curve. Now we are again finding the slope. So you know that slope is actually derivative dy by dx. So we are going to find dy by dx. In the denominator we have dx, it means that we will differentiate both sides with respect to dx. So d by dx of x cube y cube. Now we are going to take d by dx on each term separately. So d by dx of this function plus 4 times of 4 is a constant, so we are going to take it outside. So 4 times of dy by dx will be equal to the d by dx of the right hand side, which is 3x square. Now here we will use the product rule of differentiation. First function derivative of the second function plus second function y cube derivative of the first function, which is x cube plus 4 times of dy by dx will be equal to derivative of 3x square is actually 6x. Now on this side we are left with x cube multiplied derivative of y cube is 3y square, and also y is an inner function, we will write dy by dx plus you know that derivative of x cube is 3x square multiply y cube plus 4dy by dx will be equal to 6x. Now putting the values, x is 2 and y is 1. So by putting x is equal to 2, so 2 cube gives us a value 8. Multiply y is 1, so it gives us 3. Dy by dx can be written as y prime plus x is 2, so 2 square gives us 4, 4 multiply 3 gives us a value 12. Multiply y cube is 1, so it gives us 1. Plus 4 times of dy by dx can be written as y prime will be equal to 6 times of x. So x is 2, so 6 multiply 2 gives us 12. Now shift 12 to the right hand side, or we can also tell that this is 12 and this is 12, so they are cancelled with each other. So we are left with 0 on this side. Now after this, take out y dash common. So we are left with here 8 multiply 3 gives us a value 24, and here by taking out plus 4 common. So we are left with 24 and plus 4 y dash is equal to 0. So our required slope will be y dash is actually dy by dx, and dy by dx is actually equal to slope will be equal to 0. So this is the required slope of the given curve at a point 2, 1. So with this question I finish my lecture. Thank you for watching. Subscribe my channel and also hit the bell icon to receive the upcoming notification about FSC part 2 mathematics chapter number 2 differentiation. Thank you.